part.
So here is your more traditional of your work. Old, yeah. Old traditional.
So this
pattern.
Is like the spiraling energy they always add in their thing. And then this this is like this crane flying on the sky, and a group of cranes, yes. And then
the bird.
Birds, yes. And then you have these mountain and the reflection of the mountains. And in, according to the mythology, they believe in two suns. So they have the eye of the sun.
It's not the sun and the moon.
No, it's not sun and the moon. They believe in two suns. And these are the eyes of the peacock. Like they always. So combining everything, that becomes a story. So in a way, like I found it very interesting, and so I use it in most.
Please tell something about this story.
I've taken that female kind of a structure, and then it goes, and the birth happens, and this is like a cosmic thing.
This is female power.
Yeah, yeah. And also, this is like celebration. Like we, for us, if there are so much of definition, art and artist this, artist that, and a lot of academical thing and a lot of critics and research persons and all. But somehow in a simple belief for us or simple definition, if it is a definition, it's like art is nothing but celebration. So it can be the form for dance or music or art or everything. Are all self-symbolism, which I use like a kind of a self-story. And then I left it for the viewers to actually imagine how it goes.
Yeah, kind of evolutional.
Yeah, evolutional composition.
Rocket.
Rocket, you can say. Yeah, it, sometimes it looks like a rocket if you don't explain.
It's very skiffy.
Yeah.
But they look very psychedelic, these tribe things.
Yeah, they look psychedelic.
And then you use the mushroom.
And they use the mushroom and then it...
Hallucinate. Yes, a little bit, but really they were called berserks. The Vikings in the head of the ship, and they were the totally crazy ones there. Oh. They were eating and they were trying to get the people frightened.
Oh.
Like, for instance, beautiful women. Can be very cruel in some.
Yes, but that is real. Yes.
So it's like that.
My UFO.
Yeah, you see. No, not UFO. It's the mushroom kind of a thing.
Ah, yeah, this
it,
is.
It looks like a UFO, but it's mushroom kind of thing, and you see how the people are in the different activities. And that the cave style of drawing, which has its the people are actually hunting the. Reindeer or other animals, but then actually the drawing was done before, like putting a spell on the animal, and then it was killed later, giving a magical effect towards what they are doing. It's very ritualistic for them also. So that's how that the language of the drawing, first I believe in the language of the drawing more than the language of the vocabulary or the text. And that's why sometimes I'm doing this kind of work, like text. I'm trying to find out, can text be art instead of just drawing?
Yeah. Modern art is the last end of traditional art after modern art.
Anthropological art starts. The origin has to come again. It has been a global, a gradual process. And the truth is that progress is short-lived. It's only the process.
Yes.
Ymmärrän kyllä joo.
Suomen vulkaanu.
Meni heti jakeluun joo. We have an Indian artist here. It's great. We
We learn all the time. Finnish stubborns, we learn from you.
You put texts here, these are like your more contemporary paintings.
Yeah, this is like more contemporary, and this is actually what I'm going through in this, as a foreign artist coming here and trying to settle down, trying to contribute and trying to do what I can, my honest and humble way, and then I have to face all these bureaucratic things. This rubber stamp and be a Nordic, and then the low will smile. Trying to find out what can heart be. So it's like dichotomy of constructive and biomorphic heart. I put it down there. This blue, of course, it indicates the Finland's color, and then how I'm like a key entering into that. But I am also questioning the key to everything is the key to nothing. So all these kind of connotations I'm using.
But there is a diamond.
Yeah, there is a diamond.
Maybe you find the diamond here.
Yeah.
Oh, in Lapland. Yes, Diamond Sutra.
Diamond Sutra. Yes.
This you made with children.
Yeah, this was very interesting. Yesterday, there were two of them. One is like 2 years old, one is 5 years old, two girls, and they started splashing. And then I used this thing, law of intuitionalism of Croce. And then there is Jackson Pollock, for example. But this is a record of little hands with...
Yeah, little hands.
Little hands with loads of color and forms from color. It is rightly explained by someone that child is the father of man. So that just came to me, and okay, I just tried to put it.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Child is the father
of man.
Yeah.
Why you are interested in Sami people's thing?
Because
it is some similarities in your country.
Yes.
Where are you from, India?
From north eastern part of India.
From north.
Yes,
yeah. So there are similarities to Sami.
There are a lot of similarities with the music and the cultural aspects of, you know, how they deal with things and all like this.
Rituals, shamanic rituals
and all.
Yeah.
Yes.
But you tried to go to Greenland.
Yeah. But anyway,
Eskimos,
yes.
Oh, wow. No niin.
Terve.
Oh,
Yeah, that's good. So. Looks good. Maybe some flowers here like that.
Come on. Yaman varalai kasta jo
That's right.
That's right.